Have you ever wondered what makes white cement so different than its gray counterpart like OPC or PPC? Why it is more expensive than gray cement? Why do construction professionals swear by it for high-end applications? And what's the magic behind its pure, white, bright finish? In this podcast, I'm giving you a masterclass on white cement, and you'll come to know everything that you need to know as a professional or as an individual house builder who wants to know the material. Another important point, this masterclass is free, but I do have one selfish motive in return. You need to help me get this video out to as many people as possible. If you appreciate our initiative at OTF to provide unbiased, authentic information about building materials, flooring, and other related subjects, please share this content with those who need to see it. If you like what I am doing in OTF, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and give your feedback. This keeps me and my team motivated. In this masterclass on white cement, we will cover, or rather uncover, what white cement is and how is it different than gray cement. I will also tell you why is it white, that is, understanding the role of chemical elements. Then I'll explain the manufacturing process of white cement and how it compares to OPC and PPC manufacturing. Then I'll tell you technical specifications of white cement, important elements like fineness, compressive strength, and whiteness. In this masterclass, you'll come to know why white cement is not used in structural concrete. So let's get started. Namaste and welcome to On the Floor. I'm Dinesh Vyas, and in today's podcast, we are going to talk about white cement. As a professional, if you're dealing with decorative surfaces or finishes, you must know about white cement. If you are not new to this channel, you might have seen that we have already covered gray cement. Three or four podcasts are there where we have explained everything about gray cement. Its classification, how it is made, which type of gray cement should be used in which use case, and a lot of other things. All these podcasts are there in the cement playlist. But today our focus is on white cement. But before getting into white cement in detail, let's recap what we discussed in gray cement, because a lot of things run parallel. For example, in manufacturing process, the process is almost same, as you may recall. Gray cement is made by mixing limestone with clay and then grinding the mixture into fine powder. This is then heated in a kiln. The temperature is quite high, 1450 degrees centigrade. And what you get is clinker. The main product is clinker. The clinker is then ground further, and additives like gypsum are added to control the setting time, and there are a few more additives also. For PPC, fly ash is added, right? So basically, you make clinker and then you ground it with other additives. This is how gray cement is made. White cement also follows the similar process. But then there are very specific controls to preserve its whiteness. What is white cement? White cement is a type of Portland cement, similar in its binding properties like gray cement, but distinguished by its bright and white color. It's primarily used for architectural and decorative surfaces. Think stunning facades or terrazzo flooring or precast panels, where aesthetics takes precedence over structural strength. The key to white cement's purity lies in its composition and production, which are specifically tailored to achieve that pristine whiteness, at the same time retaining the cementitious properties of regular cement. Now the blunt question, why is white cement white? The secret lies in selection of raw material and control of process, plus few other things that we'll discuss. Let me first tell you why gray cement is gray. When we were discussing about the clinker, there were different components, chemistry of clinker. In gray cement, the color is mainly due to iron oxide, Fe2O3, and other impurities that the raw materials carry. For example, in limestone, there are a lot of impurities, and then we add clay also. In white cement, these impurities are not there. Particularly, the iron oxide, this Fe2O3, will not be more than 0.5%. While in gray cement, it could be as high as 4% or even slightly more. And how it is done? The chosen limestone's purity is very important. iron content is very, very low. Second, as you know, in grey cement, along with limestone, clay is added. Here, when we make white cement, instead of regular clay, China clay is added, what we call kaolin. Contamination in each stage is, you know, removed. And one more thing, the fluxes that are used in grey cement, the same fluxes are not used because they may cause grey tone. So, different fluxes are used. For example, fluorspar is used. Now, let me tell you the entire process. So, all this material in powdered form is now sent to the kiln, where at very high temperature, clinker is formed. And clinker means four basic elements that we have discussed already in grey cement: C3S, tricalcium silicate; C2S, dicalcium silicate; C3A, tricalcium aluminate; and C4AF, tetracalcium aluminoferrite. This is the main component which causes grey color. Absence of C4AF phase, we call it ferrite, that is the main reason why it is white, along with few other things. Apart from it, one very important thing happens. When the clinker comes out of the kiln, it is sprayed with the water so that the temperature immediately comes down. Otherwise, it may turn grey. Third thing, as a fuel, for grey cement, coal is used. And coal, after burning, it produces ash. In white cement, no such possibility exists because the fuel used is either gas or oil. Apart from that, there is a change in the grinding process also. And the clinker is ground, it does not use media which can have iron. So, either it has got ceramic or non-ferrous components for grinding. White cement demands premium raw materials, meticulous process control, and higher energy inputs, making it more expensive than OPC or PPC cement. Now, let's talk about technical specification of white cement vis-a-vis grey cement. In grey cement, let's take the example of OPC. OPC 53 grade, right? It has CaO around 62-65%, silica, that is SiO2, 20-22%, alumina, that is Al2O3, 5-7%, and Fe2O3, iron, approximately 2-4%, or slightly plus minus. PPC also has same component, except that it has added 20-30% fly ash. Now, what is different in white cement? The component Fe2O3, iron, goes down. Why? Because you know that iron causes grey color. Next important property in cement is fineness. Because more fineness means more area available for reaction, for hydration. The typical OPC 53 grade cement, fineness is specified around 225 square meter per kg. In PPC, because we add fly ash, this fineness is more. It's around 300 square meter per kg. And in white cement, the fineness is at next level, very high, and it goes up to 400 square meter per kg. Fineness means lot of grinding, means lot of energy consumption also. Then we come to compressive strength, Virat compressive strength. For OPC 53 grade, the 28 days compressive strength, generally 1 day, 3 days, 7 day and 28 days strengths are defined. Actually 3, 7 and 28 days, right? So for OPC, 28 days compressive strength is defined as minimum 53 MPa. For PPC, it could be anything between 33-43 MPa. And for white cement, it is little lesser than OPC, but equal or slightly more than PPC. And the last important technical thing, which is very important for white cement, is whiteness. How the whiteness is measured? In two terms. One is reflectance. White cement's reflection is 85% or more. For grey cement, it is between 20-30%. The other parameter that defines whiteness is Hunter LAB values, right? Particularly L value. So, L value for white cement is generally 90. Other parameters like setting time and all, more or less in the same range that has been defined for OPC or PPC cement. White cement is a fantastic material, but it is not used in structural concrete. And there are reasons. First reason is cost. The cost is very high. And the second reason is strength. As compared to OPC 53 grade, its strength is less. So it is not recommended for load-bearing structure, but it is good for all other purposes. And third thing is the purpose itself. Why do we make white cement? It is basically for aesthetics. Next reason is contamination. Slight contamination will turn white cement into gray. Aggregates used in concrete may stain white cement. Till now, we have discussed what is white cement, why it is white, how it is manufactured, why it is not used for structural purposes. Which all application white cement is used in. It is commonly used in decorative finishes, precast concrete elements, plastering, terrazzo flooring, bonding white marble, and for creating luxurious wall finishes. It is also used for artistic sculptures, white concrete flooring, even paint and wall putty. These are all premium finishes in high-end residential, commercial or public places. So white cement is a specialized product designed for aesthetic applications. It offers high-end finishes for decorative projects. While it has lower strength than OPC 53 grade, it excels in all non-load-bearing applications. Another important point. In India, the two brands control more than 70% of market share. JK White Cement and Birla White Cement. Put together, they control more than 70% of market share. Within these two, JK White is much more bigger than Birla White. So now you know everything about white cement. If you have any question, let me know in the comments. Or chalte chalte, fir wahi ek request. Please like, subscribe, and share this podcast with other people in your network. Thank you so much. See you in the next podcast.